Welcome to RPF. In this video, we'll discuss about encryption method or encryption technologies which is we are using in Microsoft Power Automate. If you want to understand how we can build encryption technologies and encrypt and decrypt both, then probably you can watch this complete video. So here I will show you how we can encrypt the text and file together, and after that, how we can decrypt it using Microsoft Power Automate. First, I will run this code, show you how does this looks, and after that, we'll build the complete flow in front of you. Now, if you can see here, it started executing and now we got the encrypted text. After that, exactly same text which we have provided is decrypted. Then we have started encrypting the file as well, and finally, we'll get the output file as decrypted file. So if you want to have a look about the decrypted file, we have this decrypted file where we can add the details of decryptions. So here we have third file, which is decrypted file, and here we have the decrypted file. Now, if I want to build this complete flow, let me delete everything and we'll build it in front of you from scratch. If you are visiting this channel first time and you want to learn Power Automate, please watch my Power Automate playlist. For building the complete flow, we have to just open this Microsoft Power Automate desktop versions from there, create new flow. Once we'll create a new flow, probably this will navigate us to the page. And from here, let's start building the flow. For encrypting any technologies, here we have various encryption methods. So AES is the strongest encryption method which is used in US Army. So probably this technology is not used in any other field, but in US Army, we are using AES encryption method. If you want to learn about encryption method, please add in the comment sections. Probably I will create a descriptive video about encryptions and decryptions process and will discuss over there in detail. Now, let's focus on this Power Automate thing where here we are providing the detail, or here we will provide the text to be encrypted. So let's say I'm just adding RPHub as a text to be encrypted, and here we'll add encryption key. When we are adding the encryption key, same key will be required for decryptions. So always keep in mind, whatever key you are providing, same things to be delivered to the end user so that they can use this key for decryptions process. So generally, when we are working with the encryption method, let's say we are sending a sensitive data, these data are to be delivered to the third person or to the authorized person. Let's say we have an intermediator who is sending this detail or who is working towards delivery of the authorized person. So let's say I am the person who is sending any documentations, and that documents to be encrypted, and this is the physical documents which we are sending out to any of my colleagues. So let's say we have one pool or one supporting staff who is delivering this detail with my colleague. So for the safest side, I will encrypt the complete file and send out to my colleague through that messenger. So generally, encryption method is helping us to save or store the data so that it is not accessible to the other user who is not authorized. Same way, we are also working in digital era, where if I am sending any email or any credentials or any secured informations through email or any other transmission media, if I want to encrypt it, probably I will encrypt it. I will share my code with the other user who will receive my email, so that by using that key, he will decrypt the password or he will decrypt the data. So let's add some encryption key. So let's say I'm just adding encryption key as a simple 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Click on save. So by using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 key, it will encrypt the data. So after encryptions, how the text will look, let's understand. So here I will showcase on message box, display message box, just drag and drop, and I will add your encrypted key as a title, encrypted key, and then I will add this variable, and then we are done. Apart of that, in this activity, we also have some advanced feature. So in padding, we can select any of this variations. So let's say I want to encrypt with PKCS7, then the encryption process will start with this PKCS7. If I want to encrypt with zeros, then I will add zeros. But right now I'm going ahead with the default, and exactly same technologies we'll use it for decryption as well. Key size I'm using here 256, which is the very strongest one, but it's allowed to use 128 and 192 bits as well. So as I mentioned, if you want to learn the complete process of encryptions, please add your comments in comment section so that I will create a video on encryption method as well. Now to decrypt the process, probably we'll again go ahead with the same cryptography activity panel, and here decrypt text with AES. Now exactly same variable we'll use it as an encrypt text, and then we'll provide the key, decryption key, exactly same key we are using. If any digits or alphabets will be changed, probably the decryption method will not work fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is my decryption key. And as I said, we also have same advanced technologies. So if I'm using any other fields, then probably I will not get a accurate result. So here, this is the, and then exactly same thing like key size. So this will produce a decrypt text as a variable. Let's save this, and exactly same thing we'll do it here as well. So let's change it. Decrypted key, and we'll provide decrypted text here. So that's done. Now after that, let's see, we want to encrypt the data from the file. So here we'll add some file detail. Maybe I will select encrypt file, and then we'll add encryption key. When we are converting from the file, let me show you how the file will look. So here we have encrypted file, which contains, this is the text to be encrypted. And now I will add here same key. Here we can change the key as well, because this is the second process which we are doing for encrypting the file data. So here let me add 4, 5, 6, 7. And same method we also have for advanced PK67 and 0, ENG69. So these are the technologies by using which, or these are the abbreviations value which we are using for encrypting the data. And key size is exactly 256 bits. Now, after this step, my file will also get it encrypted. If I want to showcase this data into my display, a message box, then probably I will be able to see it. I don't want to add any display message box here. So let's drag and drop decrypt to file with the AES. So here we'll select this one. And now decryption key, I will add here 4, 5, 6, 7. Decrypt to file, I will select from documents. Select decrypt, and here I don't want to add a sequential suffix, so just keep as override. Click on save, and then we are done. So let's save this flow. If we want, we can add a message box as well, but it's fine. So let's call out the folder location so that people will understand how we can showcase as a file location. So let me remove this, and then we have decrypted file. So this will display my file locations where we have saved decrypted file. Let's save this and then we'll run the code. Now it started and we got the first encrypted file with the key, and this is the data, encrypted data. Then after the decryptions, we can see exactly same RPA hub text we have passed. Then it encrypted the file, and after decryptions, we have this file available in this folder with the name decrypt.txt. So this is how we can encrypt and decrypt the data or the file using Microsoft Power Automate, which is a very crucial information or important for any security terms. That's all about this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.